האורח שלנו הפעם הוא המנצח הנודע ג'ורג' פלווניאן. התוכנית שלנו תהיה מלאה הפתעות, ולכן אני מציע להישאר איתנו, מפני שמקום הולדתו של המנצח, ועוד כמה פרטים בקורות חייו ממש מרתקים ומפתיעים. שלום מאסטרו.
שלום אריק.
I would like to start with you by discussing table tennis.
Yes. How nice to ask a maestro about table tennis immediately.
Yeah, why not?
Yes, absolutely.
I see that we have your...
My racket. It's a professional racket. I'm totally addicted to the sport. I train professionally with a Chinese coach in Paris.
Chinese coach in Paris?
Yeah. Because I live in Paris, you know. 15 years I live in Montmartre. And table tennis for me is a passion. And actually in Israel, I have a very, very good friend, one of my best friends, Tzvika Yemini, who I know for 10 years. And we play now 10 years table tennis in Yafo. Every morning when I come to Israel, I'm with Tzvika playing. And my life, one of my life ambitions is to beat him.
Is he so good?
He's so good that this is the first year, now I beat him.
By the way, I've known this person. tell me. There is a lot in common between table tennis and orchestra conducting.
Absolutely.
You are holding the racket and you are holding the baton.
Yes.
What's the difference?
The holding is one thing, but the table tennis is such a sport that you have to have perfect analyzing with the eyes of how the ball is coming to you so that you can respond to the... To the ball. And just like music, it has to be perfect. So I'm listening in music, and I'm judging, and I'm analyzing immediately what I need to who I need to react and how to get the result.
There is an incredible book, The Inner Game of Tennis by Galway, not the flute player, another Galway.
I see.
And he compares music making with tennis playing. But the difference is that in playing table tennis or tennis, you have an opponent. You have somebody playing against you.
Yeah.
So in the orchestra, somebody is against you.
No, it's not actually not at all. It's not that. It's the analyzing part of the process that is very passionate.
Yeah, Mr. Galway speaks about self one and self two within myself. That I'm talking to myself.
Okay, well that's great. I'm actually analyzing to myself and trying not to make mistakes when I'm hitting the ball. And the ball, there's a difference when there's a new ball, when there's an old ball, you can see with the new ball, it's heavier. So you have to analyze differently. When the ball is used, it becomes less shiny and it's lighter. So it's the same way with instruments. You have an instrument that is Stradivarius, another one that doesn't sound as good. So you have to judge the woodwind, the intonation. It's a very, very quickly processed that with the ears and with the eyes. I also conduct with the eyes, you know.
And the reflex. You have to take so many decisions within a fraction of a second.
Yes, if you see a score of an orchestra, it's about this big, and there's at least 25 lines on it with each bar. So you have to analyze immediately what's happening and who is doing what and where I need to look to get what result. It's very fast.
I think it's a time now for our first clip, the Capriccio Italian.
Great.
Thank you.
George, you came here as a guest of the Israeli opera.
Yes, yes, once again.
Yenufa.
Yenufa this time.
Do you love vocal conducting or you prefer the orchestra?
Listen, I do both, but I'm born in the vocal side of the music because my mother was a great singer.
Your mom was a singer.
You want to hear her? I have something.
Sure.
Listen, nobody has ever heard this before, so I'll put it on. She was a great singer. She was called the Maria Callas of the Armenians.
That's the voice of your mom.
That's my mom. She had beautiful lines.
Sounds like a lullaby.
Lullaby. She used to sing this to me when I was a baby, put me to sleep.
I'm sure you slept very sweetly.
Yes.
After this incredible voice.
Yes.
In Berlioz Te Deum, there are choirs, children's choirs.
Yes, you know, and because of the influence of voice in my life, I decided to create children's choirs all over the world a few years ago with my wife in Paris. So we have an association called the Best Musicians of the World. And we do exchanges with different choirs in different countries. And I commission the composer every year to write a piece, a new piece for children choir and orchestra. And we give the world premiere in Paris and another country.
And the Te Deum was conducted where?
In Ljubljana. That was my first year project I did when I was music director and artistic director of the Slovenian Philharmonic Orchestra many years. And so I created in the first year Paris and Ljubljana children's choirs from zero. And I put them together, and we did the Berlioz Te Deum in Slovenia. I brought all the children from France to Ljubljana for a week, and it was a wonderful experience, and I haven't stopped since then.
George, I watched you smile, and I realized that you smiled because your son is in the choir.
Yes, at that time, it was my son singing. Now, also, my daughter is singing with my son in the project.
Amazing. On the way to the studio, I heard you talking with Mustafa, our producer, and you spoke Arabic. How come you speak Arabic?
Listen, I have a very interesting story because I'm born in Beirut, Lebanon.
Can you tell it again?
I'm born in Beirut, Lebanon, your neighbor.
Oh, really? You are from Beirut, Lebanon?
Yes, absolutely, okay. Yes.
Okay, how many languages do you speak, by the way?
I speak 8 languages for the moment.
How about Hebrew?
Hebrew, 9, number 9, it will come.
And don't forget Chaval al Azman.
Chaval al Azman.
Okay. So you spoke Arabic with Mustafa because
yes.
You are born.
I'm born So I went to school, I studied Arabic. I know how to read, to write, and to speak. Not fluently now, because I haven't spoken it in 35 years. I also speak Armenian, because I'm Armenian origin. And I learned French. So I was trilingual when I was a kid in Beirut already.
What kind of language is Armenian?
It's a curious language. It doesn't resemble to anything. It's called Indo-European language, so it doesn't really resemble to. But it's a beautiful language.
Say something in Armenian.
Ուրախ եմ, որ միասին ենք, և շատ լավ ժամանակ անցնենք, որ միասին ենք.
What does it mean?
It means I'm very happy to be together with you, and we're spending a great time.
Oh, it's my privilege. And next clip is Bernstein Chichester.
Ah, yes, Leonard Bernstein, Chichester Psalms, one of my favorite pieces.
And your daughter is in the choir?
My son is in the choir, yes. But actually, there's a boy, my son is not in the choir, but I found a Slovenian boy who was singing the solo part.
You love sport.
Yes.
I heard that they have a very good football team in Qatar. Is it correct?
They're buying the teams in Barcelona and Paris. Qatar is the owners now.
How is the orchestra in Qatar?
Listen, I just went a few weeks ago for the first time to an Arab country to conduct the Philharmonic. And I must say, it is one of the best orchestras I've ever conducted.
Well, from other players.
It is unbelievably good.
Russian.
No, they're European, American, from East European also. But, you know, Lorin Mazel is, let's say, the godfather of the orchestra. And he was 1 week before me, he was there.
In Qatar. How is the concert auditorium?
It's good. It's a good opera house. It's a little bit more Italian style. It's beautiful. It's very lush. The sound, they're going to improve the acoustics, but it was a wonderful orchestra. A lot of German players and Austrian, there's a strong community. I really enjoyed it. I did the Heldenleben by Strauss.
And you conducted the rehearsals in Arabic language or in English?
Listen, it was wonderful because of my cultural background. I met about, let's say, 15 to 20 musicians who are from Arab countries.
Really?
Yes.
I thought that they are all foreigners.
No. They're actually musicians from, very good musicians, from Egypt, Syria, Lebanon, Palestine, Jordan, all the North African countries. I mean, there are many, many nice people and very good musicians who are trained, actually, in Europe. A lot of them in Germany, London, you know.
So I assume they are all young.
They're all young, I would say, between 26 to 40. the players.
Which is a guarantee for very, very high level.
It's a very high level orchestra. It's one of the, I think, one of the best orchestras in the world.
And the concert goers are the international community or the local people?
I had both. I had sheikhs coming to the concert, and I had expats. I had many, you know how many ambassadors came to see me in my room? Let me tell you. I had the Lebanese ambassador, American ambassador, French ambassador, and the Dutch Holland. All four came to see me in my room after the concert.
And the ladies, do they come to the concert? Because ladies are normally the best concert goers, so...
I saw a balance of ladies and men. I don't remember more than one.
Do they have opera in Qatar?
They do opera in concert version and stage version in a beautiful place called the Pearl, which is like, let me explain to you, like Monte Carlo.
Okay.
10 times bigger than Monte Carlo with all the yachts.
Yeah,
it's
yeah,
unbelievable.
Yeah.
What
yeah,
I
saw it on television.
Unbelievable.
And I assume the hotel was not bad.
Hotel was great. They put me in a nice suite and a beautiful hotel, so it was wonderful.
And talking about opera, we would like to put you now in the pit of the Israeli opera.
Oh, great.
What are you conducting?
Listen, the first production I did with the Israel opera that Hannah Munitz invited me, the director, is The Barber of Seville. So I think that you're going to see the overture of The Barber of Seville.
Oh, we all love it so much. Amazing. Rossini.
Rossini, Barber of Seville.
He was a good cook.
He was a great cook. He loved to eat. He was a director in San Carlo, Napoli. And he also lived in Paris, and he used to cook to all his friends.
So here he cooks the sounds in the most delicate way, in the Italian style.
Yes.
And as a real chef, he liked foie gras, didn't he?
Foie gras, and I think he created one of the filet mignon or some one of the tournedos or something.
The tournedos Rossini.
That's right, tournedos. Yeah.
You put some piece of toast and...
Yes. And I think you surrounded by bacon or something. Yeah, he did something very
and
special.
And on top of it, foie gras.
Exactly.
And here is champagne. It's amazing.
This is the different épices, the spices of
music. I like the elegance of your conducting.
Thank you. Thank you.
I can see you enjoy it.
I love music and I love opera. As I told you before, my mother was big influence in the voice. I enjoy and I live for this music experience.
I heard you doing Brahms Second. Yeah. Here is Israel Phil, and here I can see that you are having more spass.
Well, because this is Rossini, and this is light music, fast tempos, Brahms. I love the Israel Philharmonic. I've been with them 7-8 years already, but it's a different repertoire.
This is your 10th visit in Israel, or 12th, or...?
Oh, probably more, because I've been here 10 years already. Actually, the first time I came to Israel was with the Israel Chamber Orchestra. That was the first orchestra in Israel that invited me in 1995.
And that was followed by Israel Phil?
Yes.
And how many times you conducted the Philharmonic?
Israel Philharmonic, I probably gave close to 100 concerts with them. So I don't know how many visits, many, 7, 8, 9, 10 visits maybe.
And I remember you did even Till Eulenspiegel.
Of course, I've done many.
Richard Strauss in Israel.
A lot, yeah,
Oh. You are courageous.
It's a great orchestra, very virtuoso, and they have a lot of talent.
And how do you like working with the opera now?
The opera I love. It's a wonderful big house. It's a very lot of activity. We have a lot of time. And this is one of the reasons I love conducting opera here, because I can have a little more time, 4 weeks, 5 weeks, to really enjoy my friends and my, you know, different culture.
And table tennis.
And table tennis, exactly. And cooking.
Every morning in Yafo, table tennis.
Yes, every morning we play tennis.
A good reason to come for the Israeli opera.
Fantastic, isn't it?
We would like to watch you now, George, conducting Tchaikovsky in a completely contrast of mood from Rossini.
Absolutely.
Not anymore the joy of music, but that kind of...
Tragic. Passion. Tragic.
Russian style. You lived in Russia for a year.
Yeah. You know, I was Valery Gergiev's, if not the first assistant, one of the very early assistants on in the Mariinsky Theater. He invited me to the opera. And
in St. Petersburg?
Yeah, in St. Petersburg.
So you lived in the city for 1 year?
I lived in the city. You know, who was my neighbor? My neighbor was Ilya Musin, the great conductor, maestro, pedagogue.
And Russian is one among the eight languages
yes.
you speak.
Конечно, можно вместе говорить, когда хочешь, да, давай.
Okay.
I love languages.
Okay.
Yeah.
Большое спасибо, George. That was fantastic. You mentioned Mosin and Gergiev,
yeah.
The art of conducting.
Right.
Can you teach conducting?
Yes, absolutely. You have to teach conducting, and we don't have enough teachers. And this is one of the reasons I teach conducting for the last more than 10 years now. I have an academy in France, academy in Spain, and I have a lot of conductors coming from all over the world to train with me. I began, actually, the influence was Lorin Mazel, Pierre Boulez, Ferdinand Leitner. These are great names, great teachers, great conductors who gave me the principles of technique. And I created my own technique now.
And we would like to watch you in action, teaching young generation of conductors
yes.
the art of the baton.
The art of conducting, yes, absolutely. Here I'm teaching. It's a student from Norway. And I'm teaching him how he has to conduct clearly, because this is one of my principles is to be very clear in front of the orchestra. One, two, one, two. Has to be very clear. And I'm teaching him in front.
Yeah, what yeah. is the piece?
Well, the piece we're listening to is Sibelius II. And I'm teaching him how to be concentrated, have a very clear beat. He's cutting off with the left hand, now with the right hand.
Yeah.
And with the left hand, I'm teaching him how to bring the different instruments in. He shouldn't be a copycat of the left hand, should it not be different as the, it should be different than the right hand. And these are the leaders of the future, this is what I teach. And the city is Le Touquet, Paris Plage, in north of France. My academy, my festival. And it's called The Art of Conducting by George Pehlivanian.
You know, George, like always on television, our time is over.
Oh.
And there is so much I would like to discuss with you. Just like to start now the show, but unfortunately, it's over.
I'll come back another day if you want.
What is next visit in Israel?
Well, we're discussing. So we have different projects. I can't tell you right away, but we have some interesting projects coming.
Yeah, and you promise to come next time.
I will,
here.
I promise.
Okay.
I promise.
ולי לא נותר אלא לשוב ולהודות גם בעברית לאורח שלנו שמביא איתו סיפור חיים מופלא של מי שנולד בארץ שכנה ובא היום לנצח לאופרה שלנו והוא מנצח נהדר ומוזיקאי נהדר וחבר נהדר וזהו, מה יכול להיות יותר טוב?